metrics that government traditionally relies on to measure the success of the country are not necessarily a true indicator of what most people feel in their everyday lives. Using GDP per capita as a measurement of prosperity, for example, does not accurately reflect what you, me, and the majority of the population feel as it relates to satisfaction with our overall quality of life. It can also obscure the persistent and worsening issue of income inequality. Broadly, issues such as health, education, employment, the environment, personal security, work-life balance, and traffic all contribute to a perception of whether we are leading happy, prosperous lives. So I would use other methods, in addition to the usual metrics, to measure the perception of success. Methods that give us a better sense of the quality of life as perceived by residents like you and me. Then I would work to develop policies and initiatives that are aimed at achieving desired outcomes, including better income equality, which contributes overall to a better quality of life for all citizens.
The Savannah community is near and dear to my heart. I have lived in Savannah and Newlands all my life. I have always made it my mission to look out for those in our society who may not always have a voice. I have served as chairperson for the Savannah and Newlands Community Development Action Committee for the past 29 years. Working within Savannah Newlands, I have organized beautification projects, senior citizens events, neighborhood watch programs, and a host of children's activities. I love this community and I love my country. This is what we mean by community creates country. By working within our communities, we make our country better. I hope to be able to continue my community work on a national level, representing each and every one of you.
Good evening, Cayman. Good evening, Newlands. Good evening, Savannah. Boy, it's really great to see all of you out here tonight. By the sounds of the horns and the music earlier, I know your motorcade was a success. If you had some fun, make some noise. Now, I have one small favor to ask of you tonight. There are two other meetings going on tonight. One at ICCI and one across the road from Savannah Meadows. Every time you make noise, you make them hear you. This community, these communities will create country with Wayne and Heather. That's it. This is Wayne Panton's community. Well, many of you may know, but I am Nicholas DaCosta. I may not be from Savannah or Newlands, but I am from a loving community, the sister islands of Kimmambrack and Little Cayman. It gives me great pleasure to stand before you again as your master of ceremonies for the campaign finale of Wayne Panton and Heather Bodden. And I want to extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you to the campaign finale. Your support over the past several months have been incredible, and we want to sincerely thank you. This could not be possible without your support. So let's make some noise for yourselves, everybody. Whether you are here in person, streaming at home, abroad, or just right down the road, it shows that you care about the future of your community and you care about the future of your country. So you that are here, invite your friends that did not come out tonight because they're scared of little mosquitoes. Tell them we are streaming live on Cayman Life. We're on the YouTube channel for Community Creates Country. We're on Facebook for Wayne Panton Newlands, Heather Bodden Savannah, and Cayman Mall Road. So get your phones out. Tell them to tune in now, because if they're undecided, they will decide tonight to vote for Wayne Panton in Newlands and Heather Bodden in Savannah. This is your last chance to hear from your candidates before the polls open tomorrow. So make sure you have your ears open. Make sure you can remember everything they said so you can text everybody tonight and you tell them who they're going to vote for. So before we go any further, I just want to let you all know that the restrooms are right here. The portable toilets are right under this tree to your left for your convenience. And before we get the meeting started, I want to call Miss Stephanie Foster up, who you all know. She will help me bring the candidates to the stage. So please welcome Miss Stephanie.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call.
Good night, Savannah. Welcome back. Let me hear you. All right. We say that we're in Wayne Panton's area. We're in Heather Bodden's area. Well, let me hear you. And it also gives me great pleasure to welcome them on stage for you tonight. Tonight, help me to welcome Mr. Wayne Panton, your candidate for Newlands. Guys, you see the kids down here? We're doing it for them. We are ensuring that we have their voices heard. Mr. Wayne Panton will carry their voices for us for the future. Gentlemen, help me to welcome Ms. Heather Bodden, your candidate for Savannah. The voice of reason, the voice of movement, the voice of progression in this country, the voice that's always been number one in this community. Thank you all so much for being here. Your choice and your voice will be heard. We are the children. We are the one to make a brighter day. So let's start giving. You see our future? You see our future? We need to ensure that they are heard and they have a good community. For your candidates. Let these people know that they care and they're gonna cause movement here in the next 4 years and beyond.
Let's hear it for the kids one more time, please. They are the future. They are the reason why Wayne and Heather are doing this, to secure a brighter future for each and every one of them. With that bit of excitement, I invite you all now to stand for the national song. And if you will indulge me, I beg for your permission. I will sing the normal version, but there's also a favorite verse of mine that we often do not sing. And it reminds me of my favorite season here in Cayman. And can you imagine the sense of community that the Honorable Lila Rocher felt when she wrote this song? So if you know the words, please join in with me.
Oh, land of soft, fresh breezes, of verdant trees so fair, with the Creator's glory reflected everywhere. O sea of palest emerald, merging to darkest blue, whene'er my thoughts fly Godward, I always think of you. Dear verdant island set in blue Caribbean sea, I'm coming, coming very soon. Oh, beauteous Isle to thee. Although I've wandered far, my heart enshrines thee yet. Homeland, fair Cayman Isles, I cannot thee forget. Wind tired of all excitement and glamorous worldly care, how sweet thy shores to reach and find a welcome there. And when comes on the season of peace, goodwill to man, 'tis then I love thee best of all, beloved Isle Cayman. Dear verdant island set in blue Caribbean sea, I'm coming, coming very soon. Oh, beauteous Isle to thee. Although I've wandered far, my heart enshrines thee yet. Homeland, fair Cayman Isles, I cannot thee forget.
That's our beloved Isle Cayman, ladies and gentlemen. And if you remain standing, I now invite Miss Leanne Christian to open the meeting in prayer.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to say a prayer for tonight's meeting. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you abundantly for your blessings that you have bestowed upon these Cayman Islands and for your continued favor amidst this chaotic world. We humbly ask you to provide continued wisdom, strength, and refreshment to Heather and Wayne as they fulfill their calling to activate the changes needed in this community and in this country. We thank you for each member of the community, and we thank you, community, that you have come together in agreement for the success of Wayne and Heather, and we ask, Lord, that you bless each individual here tonight. May the eyes of the people continue to be opened for your path, O Father, and for the future of the Cayman Islands, as our hearts are opened to becoming one big family. Words are put into the atmosphere, and they are activated by you, O Father, creator of the universe. Therefore, I declare tonight, victory, victory, victory for Heather and Wayne, who do represent community and country. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Victory, victory, victory! I think we need a sound check. Remember, the markers are ICCI and Savannah Meadows. Are you there, ladies and gentlemen? Victory, victory, victory! You know, elections are an important time in anybody's lives, not just the country, but your personal life as well. And I remember my first election where I voted and I was so excited to go and register, and I encourage everybody to do so. So every time I'm up here speaking on behalf of Wayne or looking at Heather's group that supports her, it's always so refreshing to see so many young people that have engaged themselves in this community through these two right here in supporting their country. The next speaker that I want to invite tonight is a new voter in the district of Savannah. He is a Heather supporter, and I want you to give a special welcome to Mr. Isaiah Webster Scott. Please welcome him, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Isaiah, and I am a first-time young voter. I am not particularly versed in politics, but I do know one thing for sure. I must live in Savannah, and I must live in these beautiful islands. And my concern is the safety and progression of Savannah and this island as a whole. In order for my concerns to be addressed, I need a representative that will speak for me and this constituency, that will ensure my voice, my sister's voice, and your voice is heard. I want representatives who care. I know the two candidates here on stage tonight, Mr. Wayne Panton and Heather Bodden, are the right candidates to steer this community for the next 4 years and hopefully longer. Tomorrow, I give my very first vote ever in my life to a person that I am certain cares about our community and will support my concerns. I have the utmost faith who I will elect tomorrow, and she is on the very same stage as me tonight. I hope Savannah and Newlands will carefully choose their future by voting for change. Thank you. Let's hear it for Isaiah, everybody. That's the kind of enthusiasm that will take our country forward and will take this community to lead our country after tomorrow, right? As I told you, elections are very important to me because it changes the tide. If we don't like where we're going, if we don't like how the future is being taken care of, we change it. And that's what this is about. This is about change. We protect the generation after us, not just ourselves. Many of you may know, because I take pride in telling everybody, but I have a baby due in 2 days. I had to beg special permission to be out here tonight, but I could not miss this opportunity to let you all know that you can place your faith in Wayne Panton and Heather Bodden come tomorrow. Another supporter that is here to tell you the very same thing without a doubt is a true Wayne Panton supporter. Please welcome Mr. Robert Samuels to the stage.
I send the devil in a trouble now. Now that I know, you've given me power, you've given me authority, Jesus. Hold on, hold on. Say when the enemy comes at me like a flood, thought I'd lose hope, throw in the towel and give up. Your spirit reminded me of my first love, the power you gave me through your blood. You clothed me with righteousness and made me victorious. A heart of thanksgiving, I must declare you are glorious. Bless me with the power to tread upon scorpions. I'm already a winner by your nail-pierced hands. I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror.
Good evening. But good evening, Newlands and Savannah. You see, when I look at the Bible, I remember Isaiah 54 and verse 17. It said, no weapon that farm against you shall prosper. That enough to cover Mr. Panton. You see, I saw Mr. Panton for the first time at Truman Bodden Sport Complex, and the way he embraced everyone, I don't mean Caymanian, Barbadian, Filipino, English, or American, or you name it. The Five Planet was welcome by Mr. Panton. He embraced everybody. So I don't have a problem in choosing a candidate out of the four. Because Mr. Panton is unanimously the winner for Member of Parliament when election finish. But knowing him, I know that it won't finish right here. It will go beyond and beyond. Because he's a man without limit. He can even be a premier right now. Some people have limit, can only go this far, but he can be beyond and represent us everywhere in the world. And looking at him, I know that he's a known person. And when I say known, I mean the meaning of a place, person, place, or thing. And where am I going with this? Person, when you pluralize person, you get people. So he's a people person. And if we talk about place, we don't have to worry ourselves. It is Newland and to a greater extent, Grand Cayman and the Cayman Islands and beyond. So we don't have to worry about when we cast our vote, if we're going to cast our vote for somebody who don't deserve our vote. Because Mr. Panton deserves each and every one of us vote. So when I say people he represent and Newlands and thing, he represent everything. So he's not going to represent some religion and not embrace some religion. Because even the Jehovah's Witness is still going to represent them. They don't vote, but he's still going to have to represent them. So I know that from him. I know the type of person he is. I know how reputable and how decent this gentleman is. Because coming into Cayman Island from Jamaica, I am here like from Wapip Kill Philip. I mean, long time. So, we have to think about how great he is. So, before I leave the stage, I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell you it in the form of singing without a rhythm. I don't care what they say or do. Cawin Panton, he is here to stay, and he shall not remove him just like a tree planted by River Jordan. Mr. Panton, I say, shall not remove. Help me sing. They could have come with lightning, brimstone, and fire. They could have come like a when Ivan did pass ya. Can the same amount of water was your father now? They can't move Mr. Panton from ya. Shine on me. Me they tell you, no, say, shine on me. Let the light. From the light, oh, shine on with Panton. I say, me they tell you, no, say, shine on me. Oi, oi, shine on me. Let the light from the light, oh, so shine on me. And I say, shine on me. Help me sing, shine on me. Savannah, left it out. Let the light from the light, oh, so shine on. And I say, we are telling you, say, shine on me. Yeah, yeah, shine on me. Let the light from the light, oh, so shine on me. And I let every word of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted in God's sight. I know it is loud enough to reach the other meeting. So, you know, in a few seconds, you're going to see a lot of people Not a lot, because I didn't pass a lot, but God bless you all. Yes, sir, brother. Yes, brother.
Oi. We see he didn't pass a lot. Oi. That's to be expected, though, because they're all here. You know, you saw this lady on stage a little bit earlier hyping you all up before I did. Or actually, she helped me hype you up. So I want to welcome her back on stage now. She's going to do a bit for me. But Miss Stephanie Foster is the daughter of Denise DeMercado and Steve Webster of Bodden Town Breakers. She is a pioneer woman. Stephanie is a leader and widely known as a motivational mindset influencer. She has been the guest speaker for many support groups and motivational podcasts and Zoom coaching, both locally and internationally, and impressively manages a blog and mindset space online. Tonight, she is here to share with us. We are happy to welcome to the stage Miss Stephanie Foster, a supporter of Miss Heather Bodden. Please welcome Stephanie.
Good night again, Savannah. Good night, Savannah. Yeah, every time I call Savannah or Newlands, make some noise. Good night, Savannah, Newlands. All right. So, I am Stephanie Foster, formerly Stephanie Webster, and I am a woman of the soils of Grand Cayman. Thank you. I'm a proud citizen of Savannah, and we all know, as Mr. Wayne Panton says, that Savannah and Newlands are married. So Savannah Newlands, welcome me tonight. Aren't we just so blessed to be here tonight on this beautiful night? Aren't we? On the eve of elections. God is good. I'm happy to return to this historical area of the country in Savannah to speak to you tonight and to endorse once again my friend Heather Bodden. Tomorrow is going to be a milestone that will be embedded in the future of our kids and our generations. Tomorrow we are voting for rights, we are voting for beliefs, we are voting for values. We are voting for movement, and we are voting for the love of country. I wrote what I was going to say many times, and I changed it many times, and I scribbled it many times, and I recorded it many times, and I erased it again, because what I have to say goes far deeper than pen and paper. It is etched in my heart, and even though I have notes here tonight to guide me as I go along, it is etched in my heart the love of my community and the love of my country and what I want to see as a way forward in the Cayman Islands. You see, I'm so proud of my country because it is in need of great leadership. The passion for our future is so enormous, and I know that you all feel it here tonight. Each and every one of you are here tonight because of hope, because these two candidates have placed hope in you. Right? You see, the islands is in a need of a way forward, and you're not here by chance. You came here because you have hope, and more so, faith. You want better for this country, and rightfully so. Are we ready for a change? Yeah. Amen. I trust that when I place my mark tomorrow for Heather Bodden, she will deliver upon my hopes for this country. I know what Heather has done for this community. I know what she's done for the Savannah Primary School and its children, and the children that you've seen here tonight. I know what she has done and continues to do for community safety, for women's safety, I know the programs that she has developed, both educationally and vocationally and recreationally. And I'm so proud to live in Savannah, Newlands, and to say that I have a representative that is going to make and lift my concerns to a higher level, mine and yours. Heather is the clear choice for MP in Savannah. She has a proven and prudent leadership skills. Importantly, she knows how to bring people together and bridge divisions. Just witness the wide range of people endorsing her candidacy. The ones that are here, in your car, on the radio, on the media, thank you. Thank you. Your voices will be heard. Heather will carry your voices into every single arena that they need to be screamed in. She will. It is significant that for every citizen's interest, that Heather not only brings us a vision of progress, but also understands the nuts and bolts of the infrastructure needed to make things happen. Savannah has grown in many respects in our recent past. We can count on Heather Bodden to keep us moving with this proven brand of leadership. In the last few hours of this election eve, I trust that each and every one of you will find comfort in knowing Heather is ready and able to work for you. Amen? As I said in my last endorsement a few weeks ago, and I will quote it again, tomorrow is your most powerful day, Savannah. It is a day that you can bring back democracy to our country, right here in the very electoral district where democracy was founded 190 years ago, right here in Savannah, over there in Pedro, in Heather's backyard. Your trust will not be broken. Tomorrow, vote for Heather Bodden number one, Savannah. Thank you.
Thank you, Stephanie. And if those words weren't enough to convince you, I'm sure you all are already convinced, but if those words weren't enough, let's turn to the screen right now to hear from another supporter of Ms. Heather Bodden.
You know, all of these new candidates talk about, I believe I have what it takes to be your next representative for Savannah. I believe. Well, I will not apply the word believe to Heather. Because I know, and you know, she has what it takes. She is already representing the constituency of Savannah. Gives Heather the breath. Even when she might not feel like it, she is there for each and every one of you and for everybody in this country that comes across her path.
Do you know, do you think, do you believe that Heather's there for you? Do you know, do you think you believe, do you know that Wayne is there for you? There's no doubt, right? None at all. I know we have a lot of people here on the grass, but are there anybody in the cars? Nobody in the, everybody's out. Oh, we got some, we got some. But let's hear some noise. Let's do a sound check again. Now, you know, I thought everybody was going to come up on stage and sing a song. I was getting kind of nervous. Thank you, Stephanie, for not singing, because Mr. Samuels really set the bar high. But are there any soca fans in the house? So if I were to say, everybody on the stage, oh, Lord, oh. You know that song? If you're coming down from the mountain, oh, God, oh. Vote for Heather B. She'll be the best MP. The Savannah grass, the Savannah grass. Everybody on the stage, oh, oh, Lord, oh. If you're coming down from the mountain, oh, God, oh. Vote for Heather B. She'll be the best MP for the Savannah grass. Vote for Heather B. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to bring to you the heart, soul, and face of Savannah, the woman who gets the job done. Your next MP for Savannah, Miss Heather Bodden.
I can see the willows waving on your southern shores as the breeze it gently whispers through the trees. And the song I hear you singing floats across the distance.
That'll get us jumping. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Nicholas. Thank you very much. Wow, what a beautiful audience tonight. Can everybody hear me? Let's hear it. Let's make noise. Good evening, Newlands. Good evening, Savannah. Good evening, Cayman Islands, and to all of those who are listening over the airwaves. What a beautiful night. The winds of change are coming. Can you feel it? Woo! Can you feel it? It's on its way. Tonight, on this wonderful election eve, we wish to take this opportunity to thank all the people of Savannah Newlands, as well as all those from all over, for the love past you. I've never worked so hard in my life, but I've never been happier. I'm doing it for you all. And it gives me joy every morning that I get up and I can do something to make somebody's life feel good and more comfortable. The decisions we make tomorrow will determine our country's course for the next 4 years and beyond. I look forward to focusing my attention on the concerns that are repeatedly brought to my attention. Many of us are unhappy about our worsening economic problems, about the constant crisis atmosphere in our policies, about our lack of enforcement and strategic forward leadership. Many of us feel burdened, stifled, and sometimes even oppressed by a government that has grown too large, too bureaucratic, too wasteful, too unresponsive, too uncaring about people and their problems. I hear the unfortunate stories daily, and it just continues to get worse. We must restore hope for our people, followed by action to make their lives better. I am sure you're all hearing what we're hearing. Change is needed. Caymanians, you need to have a voice, and we are going to be your voice. Caymanians are asking, does history still have a place in Cayman for the people, for great ideals? There are some who answer no, that our energy is spent, our days of greatness are at an end. I don't believe this, but once we can come together as a community and as a country, we can always attain greatness. This ideology ends tonight. I declare, as my forefathers have many years before, on these historical grounds in Savannah and Newlands, as Stephanie said, where democracy was founded at Pedro St. James, that on April the 14th, a new day will be seen. Tonight, make it known that I, Heather Diane Bodden, is going to work even harder for you. I believe we can embark on a new age of freedom and reform in this country, and an era of national renewal, an era that will reorder the relationship between citizen and government. That will make government again responsive to people, that will revitalize the values of family, work, and neighborhoods, that will restore our Cayman Islands. I am confident I can do what is needed for you and for this country. Once you give me the opportunity with your vote tomorrow, remember, I am number one on the ballot. Please mark that X on number one. During the last 4 months, Wayne and I have been more visibly present around the community, but make no mistake, we are always here. I have always been here. This is where I grew up. This is where I have lived my life and where I intend to remain. We are not going anywhere. I would like to publicly acknowledge each one of you who have called me, sent a card, dropped off flowers. They're beautifully sitting on our desks. Sent WhatsApps or passed by the office just to say hi, thank you, and offer words of encouragement. I want to publicly say you are welcome. What I do for this community, this constituency, for you, is all for love of this country. I will ensure your voices are always heard. Ladies and gentlemen, all of this is not a list of promises. It is a plan of action. For all of the work that needs to be done, I am your candidate. I stand before you tonight to pledge my total commitment to you. I pledge to work for you and make sure requirements are met. With a team such as what we have, we can make the Cayman Islands the country it needs to be. And we will start right here in Savannah and Newlands. I am sure you will want to elect a candidate who is reachable and always available. She's right here. I am right here. Right here in Savannah, on Newlands ground tonight, but I'm in Savannah. I am sure you will elect the candidate who stands for unity, not discord, for hard work, not idle talk. This will be the last public meeting where I will see you all together before we go to the polls, and I thank you again for the support you have shown us. Before we leave tonight, I ask for your continued support as we move towards what will be the most important day in our country's future. Help me to help you, and would like to also remind you, you can continue doing the same thing. If you do the same thing, you cannot expect different results. So go do the right thing. Vote Heather Bodden, Savannah number one. Wayne Panton, Newlands, number two. Number three. It's a long day. Sorry, Newlands, number three. Wayne, I apologize. Ozzy Bodden, Boddentown East, number one. Let's do that again. Heather Bodden, number one. Wayne Panton, Newlands, number three. Ozzy Bodden, Boddentown East, number one. Ladies and gentlemen, may the best man win and the chosen woman be elected. God bless you all.
I can see the willows waving on your southern shore. as the breeze it gently whispers.
Is Heather the chosen woman? Are you going to choose her, Savannah? Everybody on the stage, oh Lord, oh, if you're coming down from the mountain, oh God, oh, vote for Heather B. She'll be the best MP for the Savannah grass. Vote Heather B. Woo! Sorry, I did not have a song for you. But I will tell you, when my wife goes back and watches this meeting tonight, if she's not watching it now, she'll realize why I listened to Savannah Grass 3 times on the way here. She said, Nicholas, you're not done with that song yet? I said, hold on, man. You soon find out. But you know, back in 2013, I was living in Miami. I was attending university. And 8 years ago, you realize that there are very few 24 and under people registered to vote. That's a fact. There are very few. But then you realize how few of them who live overseas realize that if you're overseas for education, you can actually still vote. And it's still important. When I was living overseas, I reached out to people at USF, UT, FIU, UM, everywhere in Florida that I could get to, and got them postal ballots because their voice mattered. It's already minuscule, but their voice mattered. So right now, one of those young students who actually took the initiative and the opportunity of a postal ballot, who lives in Tampa, he attends USF, and he is a supporter of Mr. Wayne Panton. He sent his endorsement. Please take a look at the screen.
Hello, everyone. I am a young voter in the Newlands constituency. Today, as a young voter, I have decided to cast my vote for Mr. Wayne Panton. The reason I am deciding to vote for Mr. Wayne Panton is not only because of the unique personal relationship that him and I have created throughout the years, but his qualification that he can bring to our government and the passion that he has for our community exceeds those of his running mates. When I first met Mr. Panton, I didn't know who he really was. All I knew that he was a minister in our government. When I had the first chance to strike a conversation with Mr. Panton face to face, we got to know each other and we bonded straight away. I expressed to him my concerns about the barriers that I face as a regular young Caymanian as I was just trying to pursue a higher education. Mr. Panton took the time out of his personal and professional life to sit with me, listen to my concerns, and did whatever in his power to help me open up doors to opportunities that would help me further my education. Mr. Panton instantly became a role model and mentor in my life. He gave and continues to give me the knowledge and advice to become a better person every day and build characteristics to serve my community in the future. I know Mr. Panton very well, and when he says that he will do whatever it takes for government to give back power to the Caymanian people, believe him. After the 2008 global financial crisis hit the Cayman Islands, Mr. Panton worked day and night as Minister of Financial Services to help the community and pull the Caymanian people out of economic downfall. Even when Mr. Panton faces defeat, he will never give up on Cayman and the people of Newlands. Although he lost his re-election in 2017, he did not stop working to better our community and our lives. Not only has Mr. Panton helped our community financially and promote mental health awareness, he has also helped us protect Cayman's most valuable asset, our environment. The Cayman Islands thrives off its environment, and when Mr. Panton saw it being threatened, he took action. In 2013, he helped enact the national conservation law that promotes sustainability and protects our wildlife and their habitats. From opportunities and finances to crisis and the environment, Mr. Panton will be there for the community of Newlands. So I urge you, my fellow Caymanians, to cast your vote for the most qualified candidate. And the man who will be there for all of us is Mr. Wayne Panton.
Mic check. Oh, there we go. There we go. Let's hear it for Albus one more time, ladies and gentlemen. The power is in your hands tomorrow. It is time for change. It is time for integrity. It is time that we, as a community, create the country that we want. Right, ladies and gentlemen? What time is it? It's time for change. What time is it? That's it. Did anybody bring a broom tonight? Because we cleaning house in Newlands. We cleaning house in Savannah. And most importantly, tell a friend, tell your mother, tell your father, we cleaning house in Bodden Town East. After Albus's speech just now, I have little more to say because you know the man with the plan, Mr. Wayne Panton. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, the former Minister of Financial Services and Environment, Newlands and Savannah community advocate and activist, the next Member of Parliament for Newlands, your candidate for change and a better Cayman, a man that will serve with integrity, honor, and distinction, please welcome now to the podium, Mr. Wayne Panton!
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here tonight. To all of you who are here present, to all of you who are online watching, thank you for joining us. We absolutely appreciate it. We love you all. Before I go on, I want to do one little thing. I got to do a little mic check. Hello, North Sound Estate! Welcome all of you. That was our little sound check, ladies and gentlemen. I needed to make sure that we could hear, they could hear us all over Newlands and all over Savannah. Oh, no, don't want me to go out to the streets of Savannah, right? Hello, Hearst Drive, Hearst Road, all the way up to Savannah. Hello, Shamrock, all the way out there. Oh, sorry. Hello, Farrell Road. Hello, Trevor Link. Yellowstone. Keystone. Trinity. Arlene, Fleet, Fifth Avenue, all of you, you know. I know my constituency. I live in the middle of my constituency. No question. Heather, you can blindfold Heather and she can find her way all around Newlands, same as I can do. Sorry, Savannah, same as I can do in Newlands. Sorry, you got number two wrong. So you can excuse me for that one. Ladies and gentlemen, again, thank you all for being here tonight. It is the last night before a very critical day tomorrow, a very important day in the history of our country. It's a day on which we go out and we vote for the representatives that we want in our constituencies and vote for the representatives that we want to represent us in Parliament and vote for the representatives that we want to hold up, ladies and gentlemen, as examples, as role models for our children in this country. So, if you want good role models, who are you going to vote for, ladies and gentlemen? If you want decency back in our parliament, and you want an excellent standard of representation, who are you going to vote for? This team, ladies and gentlemen, community creates country. This theme of this team, myself for Newlands, Heather for Savannah, our colleague Osborne Bodden for Bodden Town East. We are focused on making our communities better, making our communities stronger, making our country stronger, and making your lives, ladies and gentlemen, making your lives and the quality of your lives better. That is why we are here. That is why we have put ourselves forward. That is why we subject ourselves to public scrutiny. That is why we engage with all of you lovely people and all of our wonderful residents, in my case of Newlands, Heather's case, Savannah, and in Ozzy's case, Bodden Town East. It's because you all matter to us. And we have a desire, a passion to serve our country and to serve you, our constituents. Ladies and gentlemen, the election has consequences. So, if you're satisfied with what you've had, fine. Then maybe you don't have to go out to vote. But if you are not satisfied, if you are not happy, if you feel that the government and those people who are representing you currently have not done a good enough job, then go out and vote tomorrow for change. If you want a better standard of representation, go out tomorrow and vote for change. If you want somebody, ladies and gentlemen, who is going to be available to you, who is going to respond to you, who has an office that you can get into, vote for myself and Heather to represent you for Newlands and Savannah. You all know where our office is. It's been there for the past 4 years. All right, 8 years. But I ain't counting the time it had them letters in front of it. I'm saying that we have dedicated ourselves to serving our communities and being there for our people, even when we were not elected. Because, ladies and gentlemen, the government, the party that I was a part of, she was a part of, they abandoned us. They abandoned Bodden Town. They turned their backs on Newlands, and they turned their backs on Savannah. They turned their backs on Bodden Town West. They took on an independent from Bodden Town East who refused to join them. So why am I going to mention the first 4 years? I'm only mentioning the last 4 years because we have done that on our own without them. They had their opportunity. They had their opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, parties are about trying to build a political organization, build infrastructure within your That's a big broom. You can do a lot of brushing with that. I believe you're going with 2 or 3 constituencies already. Each swipe is 2 or 3 constituencies. Ladies and gentlemen, it's about being a part of your community. It's about getting involved with your people. And I want to explain to you the approach that we propose to take in terms of our communities. I have already told you, and you know, we have an office out there. Heather has the same cell phone number that I've always known her to have. 30 plus years. From time cell phones came around, I guess. You remember the days when you used to dial, and you only had to dial like 5 numbers? Yeah, most of the young people don't have a clue I just said, right? I remember this lady from West Bay. I can never forget her number. And I'll tell you who she was. She was the wife of the late Reverend John Gray. And she used, whenever you called her number or their house, she would sing the song to you. So you could never, ever forget it. With a little Scottish accent. 9-3-6. It's a pleasure to greet you. You could never forget that. You're going to be able to sing Heather's number. She had it for more than 30 years. My number, I've had for more than 30 years. The cards that we've handed out have those numbers on the back. They don't have no special phones created or numbers created or SIM cards inserted for election purposes. These are our numbers. She has her personal address, email address on there, as do I, because we want to be available to our people. We want to be transparent. We want to be accessible. We want to be accountable to all of you. Accountable, ladies and gentlemen. And we want to be effective. Let me tell you something. Come, baby, keep it going. Couple more strokes. Couple more strokes and you finish the island. You going West Bay now, you say? All right. When you get down by Norwest Point Road, make the turn the first, do a big old sweep in that area the first. Then go West Bay Central. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to set an example. We want to be able to deliver a service that the rest of those people who get elected with us tomorrow have to look at and want to emulate. They will want to copy how we do it because we want to be that important to you and you are that important to us. Our commitment, ladies and gentlemen, is that half of our effort and time, and I don't necessarily mean half of our time because sometimes that's not going to be practical, but I'm saying half of our effort and time, meaning We are going to have resources. We are going to have staff that are available to you that you can reach. That when you go to the office and you open the door or you knock on the door, somebody's going to tell you to come in. And if you just open the door and walk in, somebody's going to greet you and say, hello, how are you? How can I help you? That doesn't happen in the vast majority of the constituencies in this country. The vast majority. And it certainly hasn't happened in Newlands and Savannah in a long time, ladies and gentlemen. In a long time. You're supposed to go up and read a sign on a door that says, call this number, and we'll call you back. Is that good enough for you?
No.
No. That is not good enough for you. We want you to be able to come to the office, find us there, or find staff there who are going to respond to you, who are going to help you with your needs. We want somebody there who can address the specific issues that you have, or if they can't, they can make an appointment for one of us to come and meet with you at least, and we're going to do this at least once a week or more. They'll come, you can make an appointment, you can come and you can meet with us and we can address the issues for you. Then we'll have, while we're out back in whatever we're doing, if it's in central government, maybe I'm going to be accused of saying that I have these aspirations, but let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I agree it ain't nothing wrong with that. It ain't nothing wrong with that. Because if we don't want to be in a position to make policy decisions and implement policies through legislation, through secondary legislation, through initiatives, through programs to make a difference for each of our constituencies, then we're not doing what we need to do. So that is what we would like to be doing. We see ourselves as being capable of both serving you in these constituencies, ladies and gentlemen, and working in government and providing and performing at a national level to deliver on issues that help every single member of our country, every member of our constituency, every child of our constituencies. That is what is important to us. So we are going to seek to be delivering on these things. Ladies and gentlemen, I make no apologies, but we are going to be asking people for information that perhaps they have not been asked for before. We want to know, even those members, as my friend Nicholas said earlier, even those people that don't vote. And my friend, Mr. Gaddafi, even those who don't vote, they're a part of the community. You must know who they are, what their concerns are, what their issues are, because they're a part of the community. And if we work together to make all of our lives better, everybody is better off. Somebody was asking me this evening how many different nationalities we have in Newlands and Savannah. I said, well, all of them. Everyone that we have in this country, I believe, is represented in Newlands and Savannah. Every single one. We have a very diverse community that we must respect, and we must allow them to participate and to be integrated, because that is what makes the fabric of our community stronger. It is what's interesting, ladies and gentlemen, is that, and we all know that Newlands in particular is sort of like, I've referred to it in the past as a bedroom community, where people get up early in the morning and go to work, and then they come back later in the evening and they're tired. You know what? We want to change that. We want a level of engagement on weekends. We want people, when they make that turn here by Hurst Road, or they bypass and come onto Hurst Road. Let me stick to Newlands for the moment. Make that turn there, and they're coming in. I want them to start seeing things that make them feel that they are entering one of the nicest communities in the Cayman Islands. I want them to feel, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the home that they have envisioned, that they have dreamt of, because we can achieve this. We can, if you want sidewalks put on these roads, who are you going to vote for? If you want landscaping done to beautify our roadsides, beautify the park areas, you know what to do. If you want our parks that have been basically neglected, abandoned, overgrown in the past, I hasten to say in the past, because for months now, going back into last year after the lockdown, I have had friends of mine who have done a wonderful job in cleaning up those parks, making them beautiful. And we've had to take out some of the recreational equipment so that our children that want to use it couldn't get injured because it's degraded and very bad, in very bad shape. So we are going to replace all of those, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to add additional landscaping, beautify the place. We want adults to be able to utilize the parks effectively, have barbecues, or while their kids are there doing playtime and enjoying a little bit of fitness for themselves, the parents are doing the same thing because we need for them to have something useful to do. But guess what? That helps to create a healthier society too. And that's very important. You know the expression, health is wealth? Well, you all know that with the cost of insurance these days and the cost of healthcare, the healthier we can stay, the better off we are as a community. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to take a break for a few minutes for a wonderful, thank you, for a wonderful young lady who is engaged in all sorts of things that are very constructive. She loves school, she loves sports, and I mean sports plural, because there's about 6 or 8 different sports that she seems to be involved with. And she just come from some training. So I am going to allow her to come up. Mrs. Mika Leon, a wonderful Caymanian young lady. Please welcome her, give her a big hand. And I'm going to step aside for a few minutes because I know you want to hear from her. Thank you.
Good night, everybody. What a wonderful night it is to be out here. The weather is amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good afternoon. Well, good night. I am Mika Leon, and I am delighted to stand here to share my views on my candidate of choice, Mr. Wayne Panton. In the Bible, the Gospel according to Matthew outlined a parable about two builders, one who built his house upon a rock and the other who built his house upon the sand. Matthew further explained that when the rain and the wind came down upon them, only the house on the rock was able to stand because of its strong foundation. If we should do a comparison with the parable and nation building, we would have to focus on the levels that are relevant and futuristic. Those are our candidates outlined in their manifestos or practice on a daily basis. Mr. Panton has placed great, and when I say great, I mean great, emphasis on the improvement of education across the Cayman Islands. He is committed to doing everything in his powers and seeking additional resources for the betterment of teachers and students. To demonstrate Mr. Panton's stress on education, he and his team have held multiple back-to-school fun days annually where kids come and play and go home afterwards with a bag filled, ready for their first day of school, whether it be primary or secondary school. I'm sure many of us have been to those. For us as youths, the future of this country is definite. This is definitely a humongous step, better yet, a leap in the right direction. A powerful quote by Confucius says, if you want to plant for 1 year, plant rice. If you want to plant for 10 years, plant trees. But if you want to plant for 100 years, educate children. If you have been observing, you will also notice that Mr. Panton has been moving around with his team on a regular basis to ensure that a clean, healthy, and environment enriching to everyone is maintained. Proof of this are the numerous cleanups, one after another, especially in the Newlands neighborhood, that have been conducted. At a time like this, with a pandemic such as COVID-19 and the threat of other diseases, what better example to follow? What better candidate to endorse? Yes. Have you stopped to look at the theme of this man's campaign? Community creates country. He knows that the country will only be as strong and powerful as the weakest citizen in the community, so he's getting all hands on deck. We are stronger together, and we need each other to survive. We need a leader with a plan who will not crumble under pressure, one who will listen and support other people, one who will be there for us at all times and actually sticks to his word rather than just talking. So, on election day, which is tomorrow, a little less than about 4 hours, 5 hours, around there. Vote wisely. Put your X beside the candidate who is building on the solid rock. If you're in the Newlands area, vote Mr. Wayne Panton. And if you're in Savannah, vote Ms. Heather Bodden. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Very much, Mika. You and those your age, younger, and even those Caymanian children who are yet to be born are the reason that I am here tonight, the reason that Heather is here tonight. We care about everybody. We care about the elderly. We care about those who have disabilities. We care about those with special needs. But ladies and gentlemen, if we don't make decisions in which planning and proper planning is done in this country so that we know where we are going in 5 years' time, we know what we want our country to look like in 10 years' time. Who are we doing this for? And how are we going to build a foundation for children like Mika and even those who are unborn? What is our legacy going to be for them if it is not to plan properly and to take the right approach to build stronger communities and a strong country? I was talking a bit earlier, and I'm going to try to go very fast, right? I was talking about having, you know, getting data on constituents and this sort of thing. We want to know everybody in your house. We want to know your kids. We want to know how old they are. We want to know what schools they go to. We want to know whether they have any particular needs. We want to know what your concerns are in your particular places. Oh, Heather, hold on 1 second. Good evening, Saddlebrook!
Sorry I missed you out earlier.
Sorry, I had to do that. Orders. This lady is inspirational, you know. She rarely lets me forget anything. And if she forgets it and I forget it, you know what it means? I get a phone call at 1 a.m. to wake me up to tell me, you forgot that. Make sure it's done tomorrow morning. But ladies and gentlemen, we want our approach to be all-encompassing. We want to understand all the information, everything that's relevant to the lives of our constituents, so that we can, when we are looking at the broader picture, when we are looking at information as a whole or data as a whole, and we're trying to come up with policies which will improve the lives of people, we can make sure that it has the broadest possible scope and it has the broadest possible effectiveness. Because at the end of the day, as I've said, that is what we are here for. We're here for you. We're here for your children, and we want to improve the quality of your lives, whether it's through on-the-ground issues here, whether it's through the landscaping, whether it's through making sure our roads and services are up to date and people have safety. By the way, the other thing I want to do is reduce the speed limit up in here. Tonight, they can't go very fast because they've got all the cars on each side. But you see the amount of cars. And let me make a point. Is as much going that way as coming this way, so they ain't going down, no way down that way, right? You understand that, right? Ain't nothing going on down there that everybody's going to. It's as much coming out. And if they're curious and going that way, they realize it ain't nothing to go down the four, so that's why they're coming back this way. This road is a road that needs a reduced speed limit. It needs traffic calming. We need sidewalks. We need safety for our adults, for people who work in our homes, who are walking back out in the evenings or walking in the mornings. We need public transport to come in here. Newlands is a huge community now, ladies and gentlemen. Let's treat it like the community it is and provide it with the services it deserves. Let's recognize that it is important to the quality of life of our people to have all these things, have all these services. Let me tell you, if we were to count all the people that live in Newlands that are not even, I mean, if the voters list says, according to the voters list, it's 1,487. We all know it's a lot more than that. We have a big community. We got even a piece of Savannah in the heart of Newlands too. Yeah. So we know that we have a big community here that deserves quality services, deserves attention, deserves more than a WhatsApp every now and again, which copies something from GIS, which says, yeah, they didn't pick up the garbage this morning, but they're gonna pick it up tomorrow morning. That is not good enough, ladies and gentlemen. We need to have representatives for all of our constituents who are proactive, who are going to find out what the issues are, who are going to try to address the issues before they become issues that are difficult or unmanageable. Sorry, mouth getting dry, everything tying up. Before they are unmanageable, we need to address these issues. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want opportunities for your children, if you are concerned that this country is on a path, and it feels like a runaway train, it feels like it's speeding somewhere, and you all are being left behind, your children are being left behind, they're beginning to feel that there are no opportunities for them, irrespective of the kind of education they get, because we have lots of Caymanians that are getting much better education, much more opportunities, but even those, ladies and gentlemen, are finding that they feel threatened. They feel like they're losing, like they're being disenfranchised in their own country. And we cannot allow that. His
my friend Nicholas is going to have a baby in a few days. Yeah, but you sit there about 2 days. It might be around 2 days, but you don't know exactly when. Not unless you got an appointment with a doctor that's specific to you know what. Okay, see that? He going to Brock tomorrow to vote. He doing his civic duty. He better hope that that baby don't decide to come tomorrow, right? But it is. Salute. Seriously, ladies and gentlemen, if you want our children, if you want to feel that our children can have hope, if you can have hope for them, then you know what to do tomorrow. It is one of those days that you have every 4 years. Well, a little bit shorter this time. But around every 4 years normally, where you can go out there and exercise your democratic right to make a change, to formulate, to help to formulate a government, to help to formulate principles, policies, values that you want to help your country, you want to get the benefit of, and you want reflected in your representatives. So tomorrow is an extremely important day, ladies and gentlemen, and we need you to get up early in the morning. I'm not going to keep you too much longer because I want you to go to bed early. I want you to get a good night's rest. I want you, ladies and gentlemen, to wake up resolute in your intention to go to the polls. Go early. Go mid-morning. Don't wait too late. Don't wait much past that. Because you want to go and vote. Get that out of the way, and then you can have the rest of the day. What you do not want, ladies and gentlemen, is to go to the beach, get a little bit of sun, have a couple of sugary drinks, come home nice and relaxed, a little bit sleepy, go take a shower. Oh, let me stretch a little bit. Let me lie down. And then you wake up, and it's 1 minute to six. That's not what you want, ladies and gentlemen. Get up early tomorrow morning and plan to get out there early and vote. Get it out of the way. Ladies and gentlemen, the elections folks have been doing a great job. We have one of the best teams that run elections I've seen anywhere. And I have a lot of confidence in them. I am very proud of them as Caymanians who are enabling us to make some of the most important decisions in our lives, in the lives of our children. Go down there tomorrow morning to ICCI for Newlands. Go out to Savannah School for Savannah. Vote number three.
Heather.
Number three.
Heather.
Number three. Vote number three for. Woo! Vote number three for me. That's my number. And if you don't, if your eyes are a little bit blurry and you got all of a sudden you got a headache or something, look for the picture. I'm the guy with the blue shirt on. It's a blue t-shirt. You know why it has a blue t-shirt, ladies and gentlemen? You know why? You know why we're not dressed in jackets? Who is going to wear a jacket and come out in your neighborhood and work for you? Address the issues that you need. Who's going to put on a jacket to go and do that? If you are hiring somebody to come to do a specific job, if he's coming to be a receptionist or she is coming to be a receptionist, you want him dressed like a welder? No. So we wear the blue t-shirts that say community creates country because that's what we believe in. That is our theme. We're committed to our communities,
and we're committed to our country. We are going to deliver for both. We are going to do it in a way and to an extent that others have not done in this country, because we have sat back and we have watched, we have seen where the failings have been. We have had one term now on the single member constituencies. And everywhere, not just this constituency, not just that constituency, many of them, I'm not saying it's unique in here, but it is very prevalent in here as well. You go around and people say, I have not seen, even though geographically it's small, but otherwise it's fairly dense from a population perspective. I have not seen this person. I have not seen my representative. And we hear that Heather hears the same thing in Savannah. There are others too. But that is not good enough, ladies and gentlemen. We want to be in a situation where we have data, we have information, we have a system, so that if we haven't talked to you in 6 months, we get a little yellow alert. And I say yellow alert because I'm meaning it's not on paper. It's not going to be a stack of paper in the office. It's going to be maintained electronically. That we will get a yellow alert which tells us if we haven't talked to you in 6 months' time. And then if it gets to 9 or 10 months, it's going to go red, which means we need to get in touch with you because it's been too long. So that approach, ladies and gentlemen, is going to guarantee us that nobody is going to come along and say, I ain't seen you in 4 years. At least they're not going to do it and tell you the truth about it, right? Because we're going to make sure that we are there for people. We are going to make sure that we are touching people. You know how, you know, let me tell you some of the other, like, let's take Barbados as an example. You know, after every election, you know what happens? Well, no, let me back up for a minute. You know what happens before elections, right? You've seen it. You know, for 6 months, 3 months, you get a lot of canvassing going on. People are coming around. People get to the point where they start ignoring the knocks on the door, right? I can say that now because tomorrow morning is election, right? I wouldn't say that like a week or two ago. But that's what you used to hear. Let's take Barbados as an example. They do that too. They do that. But immediately after the election, they go right back to it. They go right back to canvassing. They're not pounding your door down. They're not bothering you. They're coming by in a very respectful manner, checking on you, touching base, seeing how their community is going, looking at the conditions of the roads, seeing what they need to proactively respond to. That's what we want to be doing. That's what we need to be doing, ladies and gentlemen. We, ladies and gentlemen, should not be forgetting about our constituencies for 3 3/4 years after the election. So, ladies and gentlemen, please, tomorrow morning, go out. Get up early. Get some rest tonight. Go out. If you need a ride, contact us. 329-5000. Contact that number. 329-5000. If you need a ride, because we have buses that are going to be available going around in the community to make sure that people don't have a reason not to get on the bus, go down there. We want maximum convenience. We want them to be able to just hop on that bus. It's going to be air conditioned. You'll be provided with a mask. You're going to be seated several seats apart, so it's not going to be crowded. And you'll be taken straight to the polling station. You'll get off there. You go and vote. And then you can come back out and catch another bus. Just tell the driver where you get off.
If it's not the same bus, they might remember. Just tell them. They'll take you home. They will take you home. They're going to treat you like family. They're going to take you home, ladies and gentlemen, safely. So, please, for us, for your country, for yourselves, for your children, please go out, vote tomorrow morning. If you need a ride, 329-5000. If you're going, if you're walking, plenty of us can walk there. I go walk tomorrow morning. We can walk there. We can walk down Freedom Street. We're going to have to rename that little part of Hearst Road. That end piece from ICCI into Rackley and even down around the corner, down past Whispering Waters, down past Shams Floor, down past Candover, down into Sunrise Landing. We can name that whole thing Freedom Street. On it can walk, come. If you want to exercise, let's go. But that's what we need to do, ladies and gentlemen. We need to do that to make a difference in this country. I want you to understand something, though. In terms of priorities for us, for Heather, myself, Osborne Bodden in Bodden Town East, our first priority, ladies and gentlemen, as much as I have said, we are going to make sure that our communities are serviced like never before. As much as I've said that, our first priority, I will have to tell you, is going to be to make sure that our country is strong. Our country is strong together. Don't believe them signs you see down there, running on propane with all them big bright things that say strong future and all that kind of stuff. They want you to believe that they are the only ones that can provide strength. That is not the case, ladies and gentlemen. That is not the case. I'm not saying that some of them can't, but we can see. Look at the signs. We can see there's a bunch of people there on some of those signs that really, you know, you ain't gonna add no strength to nothing. Right? That it adds numbers. It has numbers. It allows somebody to make a claim that they have certain numbers, but it ain't going to add no strength. Ladies and gentlemen, I am appealing to you to examine myself, Heather, and Osborne Bodden in Bodden Town, and you decide if we can add more strength. You decide if we can add more strength, because I know that I can. I know this lady here can. And I know Osborne Bodden can. So talk to your friends. All three of us have legislative experience. Osborne and myself are former ministers. In fact, in a version of the government that exists today. Not the same government, though, you know, not the same BBM. Different BBM. Better PPM back then. Yeah. Not today. We are all experienced. You can trust us. And we are telling you that our first priority is the country and making sure that our country is strong and safe. Our second priority is making sure that our constituents are well taken care of. In fact, I want to say it's more like side by side, really. Because I know that if we're taking care of our constituents, we are taking care of our country. We are making our country strong. But way down, ladies and gentlemen, way down on that list of priorities is any kind of affiliation, any kind of team. And that means that means this team coming to create country as well. I'm telling you what our priorities are. Our priorities are to the country, to you, and to you, our constituents. It has nothing to do with us as individuals, our personal interests, or
even necessarily the team. This is a platform that we think we can build strength in, but our priority is you, the people. Our priority is our country, ladies and gentlemen. That is our priority. So, ladies and gentlemen, please, tomorrow, go out. It's very important. Get your vote out of the way. Go and enjoy our beach after that. But let me quickly tell you something. Go down in the south end of 7 Mile Beach, which is a national asset of this country. Go down there and see what's going on down there. Look at what is happening in our country because of bad policies, because of bad decision-making. Go and look and see if you can find a beach behind the Marriott or down behind those various condos around there. Even as far up as Royal Palms and stuff, lots of erosion. It's a tragedy, ladies and gentlemen. It is a tragedy, and it has been decades in the making, and the reason it has been in the making is we have made decisions which are not in the interest of this country. We have put aside science. We have put aside even common sense in some cases and made decisions on the basis of greed. And that does not serve the people of this country, ladies and gentlemen, because that asset belongs to all of you too. Even if you live in Newlands, even if you live in Savannah, even if you live in Bodden Town East. So, ladies and gentlemen, I am going to wrap it up. I implore you, as I've said before, I can keep repeating it, come out tomorrow morning, vote, get that out of the way. Number three, that's me. Number three for Newlands. Number one for Savannah. Number one for Bodden Town East. Number one for Bodden Town East. I go in reverse order. Number one again for Savannah. Number three for Newlands. Ladies and gentlemen, sorry? Did I say something wrong? Okay. You okay?
Yeah.
All right. I think Ozzy came up with something a few weeks ago. He said, dial 113 and it'll set you free. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here tonight. I want to thank Nicholas DaCosta for doing such a stellar job as usual as MC. He's a dear friend. He's a wonderful young man. I wish I could sing like him. You mightn't wish that because I'd probably be up here longer. But I wish I could sing like him. He's a talented musician, incredibly intelligent young man. He is one of the assets of this country that we seek to make the country better for too. Congratulations, Nicholas, slightly ahead of time. And I hope that everything goes well. I hope that you get to go to Cayman Brac tomorrow and vote and come back home and then have baby. All right? Let's give a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, to Nicholas, so we can also congratulate him. He there was a time he was interested in politics, but I believe it could be a few years of no sleep before he decides he's interested in politics again. Not true? If you don't know it, I can tell you. But this fine young man, ladies and gentlemen, has an incredible future in this country. And one day, you will see him. One day you will see him even being the premier of this country. And he will make an incredible premier. So, not at the same time, but. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all. Heather, thank you for being here. Thank you for being patient with me. Thank you for being a colleague. Country, the people of our constituencies. Because we know
what our commitment is together to represent all of you. Savannah is connected to Newlands. It's inextricable. And we want to deliver a seamless, incredible service that you have not seen as representatives in this country anywhere. That includes Bodden Town East. Tell your friends, ladies and gentlemen, to go and vote for number one in Bodden Town East as well, while they're coming out and you're coming out to vote for number one in Savannah, those of you who are Savannah voters, and number three in Newlands. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Have a wonderful night. We love you all. We love you all, and we love you, Newlands. We love you, Savannah. Heather, not loud enough, so I can say it. We love you, Savannah.
We love you, Savannah. We love you, Cayman Islands.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. God bless. Be careful and go vote. Yeah. And party.
No, it's...